May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be always pleasing in your sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Please take a seat. So in the Gospel reading today, Matthew 13, there is a whole range of parables and aphorisms, short sayings. And there's a lot of material there for a number of sermons. I'm not going to preach all of them, it's okay. But there's one there which it sort of jars in my mind. So Jesus is talking, he's giving them a whole bunch of parables, and he says, "Do you understand?" And they all go, "Yeah." I think I'd be going, "Yeah." I have no idea, no. And he says, "Therefore, every teacher of the law who has become a disciple in the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of a house who brings out of his storeroom new treasures as well as old." Please explain. Jesus doesn't explain that. He just leaves it there. My thinking on it is this. In our society, and I suspect this is true of human beings, we tend to either value that which is old or that which is new. And some people are collectors of antiques, and they value that which is old. Some churches are collectors of antiques, and they value the ancient traditions. We can't change. We've always done it that way. Some are collectors of the new and shiny. We need the latest gadget. We want the latest thing. We can't do it that way. We did it that way last week. Imagine we did it the same way two times in a row. It was good last week. Oh, yeah, but every teacher of the law who has become a disciple in the kingdom, the law of Moses, that which is of ancient times, and the disciple in the kingdom of heaven, a present tense follower of Jesus Christ. It's like the owner of a house who brings out of the storeroom new treasures and old. Possibly we're called to find treasure both in the old and in the new. With that in mind, I want to turn quickly to our Genesis reading. I'm going to get on my high horse for a moment here. At the moment in Australia, there is a conversation around what is described as marriage equality. And a lot of people are getting very heated up over this as a topic of conversation. And the languages around, well, the question around at the moment is this: in Australia, should the law be changed so that two people of the same gender can get married? That's the conversation that the government is having. And should we have a plebiscite? And should we have a postal vote? And should we do it? Look, in one sense, I don't care. I'm already married, and I have no desire to be married to a man. So it doesn't actually impact on me personally in that sense. But where I get riled up, is when there are people who would claim to be against this on the basis that it doesn't reflect the biblical picture of marriage. And then we read the Genesis where Jacob's in love with Rachel, so he buys her for 7 years. That's his wages. He buys his bride, but dad tricks him into marrying the older sister. So they do a bit of horse trading, so he ends up purchases two sisters to be his bride at the same time. So anyone who says we've got to stick with a man and a woman as an exclusive contract because that's the biblical picture of marriage and it should be self-evident from what we read in Scripture, They're not doing the work. And that makes me grumpy, because that's bad theology. They haven't gone into the storeroom, they haven't found the old treasures and dusted them off and actually looked at them. Now, you might come to one position on marriage equality, and I might come to a different position, and that's up to us. But please don't pretend it's a simple debate based on the biblical picture of marriage, because then you get to buy your spouse, as long as you're a bloke. And they are your possession, because that's fine. The biblical picture is more complex than that. You need to do the work. Or otherwise you might just throw away the old treasures. A more modern, a newer treasure, scripturally speaking. I want to look at this. Now, is it one parable or two? I'll read it. That's the first question I have to ask. Is this one parable or two? Is Jesus repeating himself and telling two stories? The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it. Is Jesus repeating himself? Is he telling the same story twice? Is it one parable, one story? The way I grew up with understanding this is that it's the same story told twice. It's Jesus repeating himself because it's an important idea. And that this is the idea that God, Matthew is Jewish, so he has great difficulty in writing God, because for them that would have been profoundly disrespectful. So God is of great value, and we should be seeking for that more than for anything else. And that's fine as an interpretation. And it fits the first one. God is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man or a person found it, they hid it again, and in their joy went and sold everything they had and bought that field. And can you imagine being some sort of a day laborer, presumably? You're working in a field, you're picking grain, you come across a box of buried treasure. Yes! I'm going to go and sell everything. I'm going to buy the field and the treasure is mine. That's the joy we should have in finding God. But the second one is slightly different. God is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. See the difference? This time, God is the one doing the seeking. My suspicion is this, that is a deliberate piece of storytelling from Jesus. And that what Jesus is painting for us is a picture of the value for us in seeking for God and the assurance that God is reaching out to us. That certainly fits our experience with Jesus Christ, being God reaching out to us. There is profound value in knowing that for us, as we seek for God, like a day laborer in the field, God seeks for and values us. We know that we are wanted by God. It is deeply important to us.